The cats are gradually being introduced to some of the more terrifying aspects of their new home. In this case, a steam pumping engine, which once helped to open the bridge's arms and now serves as an exhibit for visitors. Victorian technology can be pretty awe-inspiring, especially when you're only 5 months old, and it'll be some time before they're allowed around here on their own. The twins were provided by the Animal Protection Trust after their owner could no longer look after them.
They're delighted with their living quarters and the attention they're getting. They don't like the noise of the engines here in the engine rooms and perhaps the people rushing around.
Do you think they'll get used to it?
I think so, yes. Once they've settled in happily, this won't be a problem. It'll be somewhere to explore for them.
At present, most of their time is spent in their quarters in the bridge storeroom, where they're slowly getting used to their new lifestyle. One of the cats has appropriately been christened Bridget. The other is called Gladys, after a vintage Thames barge. The staff say they're a necessary addition to the payroll.
There's so much redevelopment work going on in the area, and we thought that if we had a cat, it might detract the odd mouse that tends to walk through the premises.
What are their sort of official pay and conditions, as it were?
Well, they are employed by the Corporation of London. They are on the establishment. Their wages are their cat food and any veterinary fees that they may incur.
For now, the cats are content to draw their wages until their killer instinct develops. At present, the mice don't have a lot to worry about. John Taylor at Tower Bridge for Thames News.